Well, morning, and it is a frigidly cold morning. Very cold today with increasing clouds around the area. Temperatures actually rise as we go into the night and we spin the winds around to the southwest. And that's good news for us tomorrow as we begin a sunny warm up for Chicagoland. Right now, though, 15 degrees. That's all you got. 15 degrees. This is wintertime weather, folks. This is the kind of thing you see in January in Chicago. 4 degrees is all we have for a wind chill, and northwest winds at 8 miles an hour. So it's 15 in McHenry and O'Hare, and 17 in Midway, 16 at Aurora, 14 at DeKalb, factor in the winds, and it feels like zero at Aurora, zero at Ottawa, 4 degrees at O'Hare. Nice sunshine, but later today we'll bring more clouds into the picture as we bring that warm air in here. 26 degrees, increasing clouds as we go into the afternoon hour. And 26 at O'Hare, most everybody in the same area, about the mid-20s across northeast Illinois and northwest Indiana. Tonight, 23 degrees, partly cloudy, and the temperatures rise a bit. Tomorrow, 39 degrees at O'Hare, but I think a lot of you are going to get to 40 or so around the area. No reason to believe that we wouldn't with these winds that start coming out of the southwest, as you can see the wind arrows here. That'll warm us up nicely. So that begins a nice trend. 26 frigid cold today, 39 tomorrow, 44 some rain by the afternoon hours on Thursday, Friday 41, and then 42 Saturday, 47 on Sunday, and Monday 45 degrees. Adrena?
Ooh, I like the sound of that one. 47 never looks so good, Ed. Thank you. It is 4:46 right now in your morning sports. Bears taking on the Minnesota Vikings in Monday Night Football. Did you stay up to watch? We got you covered here this morning. All right, we know finishing games and not blowing them has been the focus for Justin Fields and the Bears all week. Well, Fields was given another chance to try and redeem himself last night, but he wasn't the one putting up any other points. All right, Bears trying to make wishes come true at Bank Stadium against the Vikings. The defense did all they could to make that happen. Jalen Johnson coming down with his third career interception. Later, TJ Edwards picks off Josh Dobbs. The Bears actually intercepted four of his passes. All right, up 9-3 in the fourth, but Justin Fields committing costly turnovers of his own. He fumbled twice. Dobbs marched down the field, found TJ Hockenson for the first touchdown on the night after this one. And Fields took accountability and got back to work, finding DJ Moore for a 36-yard gain, 58 left. That sets up a 30-yard field goal attempt for Cairo Santos, who knocks it through in the final seconds of this game. The Bears do not score a touchdown, but pick up their third primetime win of the season, 12-10 the final. They finally get a division win under Matt Eberflus.
Guys never wavered. So the guys in the locker room, appreciate them for, you know, sticking beside me and, you know, believing in me. And, you know, defense did a great job by getting us the ball back for that last drive. And offense did a great job executing those plays. So felt great and really just felt good of, you know, fighting through the adversity.
I mean, it was just really just taking that next step and really finishing. I mean, we talk about it, we work on it, but, I mean, at the end of the day, we got to execute in the game. And it was just happy to see them execute.
We just got to continue to work on this finish, man. It wasn't pretty, but we got it done, you know, so we just got to continue to come in and improve at it. We got a week to let this one soak in.
Well, a team the Bears have had a very close eye on this season will not be finishing with their head coach. The Panthers have fired Frank Reich after getting off to a 1-10 start in his first season, being led by rookie quarterback Bryce Young, who has also really struggled. Two of the three teams the Bears have beaten this season have now fired their head coach. Now remember, the Bears hold the Panthers' first-round pick, so lots of eyes on that team. And Northwestern hosting Northern Illinois after a 9-day hiatus. Zarik Nutter off a turnover. Xavier Amos cleans it up for two of his career-high 26 points. Huskies up one of the half. Second half, all Northwestern. Boo Booey knocks down the triple. He led the team with 23 points. Then Booey finds Matthew Nicholson for the slam. He added 15, a career-high 6 assists. Cats win this one, 89-67. Well, billions of dollars have been spent online this shopping season, and the trend is likely to continue. How this is giving the economy a much needed boost. And here at 4:49 this morning, getting an early look at our expressways. We're all green, so no slowdowns right now, but of course, we'll keep a close eye on your roads as we get busier in the morning. Welcome back this morning. Well, CBS Chicago cares, and today is our 12th annual Day of Giving. In a little more than an hour, we are opening up the phone lines and collecting as many donations as we can to help the American Red Cross and all the life-saving work they do. Did you know the Red Cross supplies 40% of our nation's blood supply? That's a big demand. Teams are busy year-round trying to stock Chicago's 5 hospitals and other trauma centers across the country for emergencies and other treatments. That means 1,200 people need to give blood every day just to keep up. Well, if you're willing and able to donate blood, please consider helping. You can also make a financial donation, too. Here is a look at your screen, all the ways you can help. You can use your phone or tablet to scan the QR code on your screen here. You can text Red Cross to 90999 to donate just $10. Every little bit helps. Or you can head to our website, cbschicago.com/redcross. If you'd like to speak with someone live about a contribution, you can call our phone bank anytime after 6 this morning and speak to one of our volunteers. The number on your